Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to discuss about arrays. Before discussing about arrays, we should know what is the need of declaring this arrays. Till now we have seen, if you have two numbers, you are going to declare two variables, and if you want to repeat the same set of statements, you are using loops. If suppose I am having 10 variables of same data type, instead of declaring it as A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, what I am going to do is, I am going to use the array A of 10. If you are declaring a variable of same data type more number of times, then you are going to use your arrays. The fundamental data types, namely character, int, float, double, and variations of int and double, can store only one value at a given moment. Therefore, they can be used only to handle limited amount of data. In many applications, we need to handle a large volume of data in terms of reading, processing, and printing. To process such large volume of data, C supports a derived data type called as array that facilitates efficient storing, accessing, and manipulation of data elements. So, in brief, I can define that array is a collection of homogeneous data elements that share a common name, and each and every element have its own memory to store that particular value. See here, an array is a fixed size sequential collection of elements of same data type. Example, where you are using the arrays is list of employees in the organization. Okay, instead of writing the name of an employee, in an organization 100 employees are there, instead of declaring 100 variables, what I am going to do is, I am going to write one array called as employee within the square brackets 100. That means limitation is 100 employees. The list of the products and their cost, test scores of the students, and list of customers and their phone numbers. All these you will store using your arrays only. Since an array provides a convenient structure for representing data, it is classified as one of the data structures in C. Types of arrays are one-dimensional, two-dimensional, and multi-dimensional. Now we will see each dimension in detail. One-dimensional array. A list of items can be given one variable name using one subscript, and such a variable is called as your single subscript value or a one-dimensional array. If you are using only one subscript, okay, then that is called as your one-dimensional array. If it is two subscripts, two-dimensional, n subscripts, n-dimensional array. How you are going to declare an one-dimensional array? It is like you should be able to, like another variables, array must also be declared the memory before compilation, and you should allot the space for them in the memory. Say for example, syntax of this one dimension is type, which is nothing but your data type, variable name, and the size. Size represents the number of values it can store. Int number 5. This represents that the number is the name of the array which can accommodate 5 values, and all those 5 values are of type integer. This declares the number to be an array consisting of 5 elements. Any subscript 0 to 4 are valid, and the computer reserves 5 storage allocations, which is as follows: number 0, number 1, number 2, number 3, and number 4. So before discussing this, the array subscript value starts from 0 and ends with n minus 1. If the size of that array is some 10, then it starts from 0 to 9. Like that, that array will be declared. Any reference to the arrays outside the limited declared limits will not necessarily cause an error. That means if I am declaring it as some a of 5 only the size. If I am going to assign the value for a of 6, then it throws an garbage value. Okay, so while initialization of your one-dimensional array, it contains, when declared, it contains all the garbage value. While initialization, it assigns that particular value to that particular location. Generally, you are going to have two ways of initializing your one-dimensional array. One at the compile time, the other at your runtime. Compile time initialization. We initialize the elements in the same way as an ordinary variables, like your data type, array name, size is equal to list of values. Int number is number of 5 is equal to 5 numbers it is going to allocate. Okay, if it is floating point values, floating. If suppose the size is 5 and you are assigning only 3 values, what about the remaining 2? The remaining 2 is automatically set to the value of 0. So what is here, total of 0 is 0.0 and total of 1 is 5.2 and total of 2 is minus 10 and total of 3 and 4 are 0. So see here you are writing it as int number 3 and you are giving it as 4 numbers. Then this type of declaration or initialization is called as illegal initialization of array values. Okay, so you can omit the size also and you can declare like int count like this. That means how many values you can have, that many. If it is empty, you can initialize any values or any number of values in the parenthesis. Now, if it is a character array, we will write it as char name and you will enclose each and every character within a single quotation or else the complete string within the double quotation. Runtime initialization is nothing but here you are going to use your scanf. Scanf percentile d ampersand that particular array name with the subscript value, or else if you are using for loop, you are going to write it as I. So this is the program to find the minimum and the maximum and average in an array of elements. See here what happens. I am declaring A of max. What is the max value? This I have declared symbolic constant max as 100. That means I am declaring an array of size 100. Minimum value, maximum value, s is equal to 0, n, I. Average will always be in your float. You will read the size of the array. You will read the elements using scanf. You will print the elements using printf. Now see here how to find out the first minimum, maximum, average. So what I am going to do, before calculating the average, I should find out the sum of the elements in the list. So for that I am using for loop. For I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, s is equal to s plus a of I. So I will get the sum here. Average, I will typecast this as floating point value by n. Now I will initialize minimum and maximum. That means I will take the reference of the first element as the minimum and maximum element, and I will compare with all the elements in the list. How? If a of I is less than minimum, minimum will be a of I. If a of I is greater than maximum, then maximum element will be a of I. In that manner, I am going to manage. Finally, I am going to print the maximum element, minimum element and the average of all the elements. So, this is all about your one-dimensional array. Thank you.